Hey everybody, in this video I'll talk about the addition of the Digital Human Shader's head shader, which will divide into two tutorials, one on general use and the other on advanced applications. This video will talk about the general usage of the shader textures and sliders, as well as some things you should be aware of when using this shader. Here we have a pretty realistic looking female character, along with a light attached to a ball inside the scene. Now when I rotate the spotlight to the back of the character by pressing the E button, you can see that the ear has a strong translucent effect. Let's hide the spotlight gizmo, select the character, and take a look at the material settings. Inside the material list, under the Modify panel, one can see several digital human shader materials under the Shader Type field. Let's select the head to focus on the digital human head shader. Take a look at the Shader Settings section under the Texture Settings section to see the subcategories like textures, micronormal, roughness, etc. Let's expand the texture section and take a look at the transmission map. Transmission map determines the degree of light transmission. The wider the map, the more transparent it becomes, like the area around the ears where there is an obvious light transmission effect. There are some functions for this transmission map accessible via the buttons below. However, they are disabled because the texture is referenced from an external image file as evidenced by the link icon on the lower left corner of the thumbnail. You can press the Open Path button to reference another external texture file. Or press the Embed button to include the texture with the project. After the image is embedded, you can use the Two Image functions for adjusting the color and launching the texture in an external application. Let's position the light to the side for better observation and see that the nose has little to no transmission effect. I'll go ahead and launch the transmission map into an external image editor and blot out the nose, mouth, eyes with white color and save the file. After returning the texture back to Character Creator, the nose now has transmissive lighting. By increasing the brightness with the Adjust Color function, I can magnify this effect. If I delete the transmission map, the result is automatically calculated. However, this may not be suitable for all situations, therefore it is best to provide a texture map. If the texture is deleted or modified beyond repair, you can always press the reset button to restore the texture to its original state. Now let's take a look at the SSS map, which is used to control the subsurface scattering effect. Black areas don't take effect, while white areas do. Let's expand on the subsurface scatter section to see the SSS falloff followed by the SSS radius attribute. The SSS falloff is the color used to simulate the translucent scattering of light into a material after it has entered it. If I change it to red, you can see that the translucent color of the ear in the shadows near the bridge of the nose will also take on this hue. The SSS radius is used to simulate the distance of the scattering. The larger the value, the larger the range of the effect. You can directly enter a number into the spin box that is greater than 3 to increase beyond the limit of the range slider. When I spin the light around, you'll notice that the shadowed areas of the head has a distinct red glow. Now let's talk about micronormals, which is associated with the micronormal mask and micronormal texture channels. By increasing the tiling, the map is repeated more often and the texture details become finer. One can also change out the micronormal texture to achieve different effects. The strength setting can be adjusted to achieve the desired intensity. The mask texture can determine which areas are affected by the micronormal effect. The white areas of the texture take effect while black areas don't. When I fill the area of the face with pure white, the micronormal effect on the nose and lips becomes quite obvious. The digital human head shader also provides more adjustability for the roughness channel. Keep original roughness lets the roughness texture override the entire roughness setting for the material. When this is not checked, the roughness of the shader is determined by the shader itself. This offers additional options like individual adjustments of the roughness attribute for the nose and lips. Now let's take a look at the specular and ambient occlusion settings. The specular mask is used to determine which areas are subject to specularity. White areas of the texture take effect while black areas don't. The specular parameters refer to the degree to which the color of the character is affected by highlights. The inner mouth AO is used to control the ambient occlusion intensity inside the mouth cavity. The larger the value, the stronger the AO effect. The MN mask and AO texture can be used to determine the ambient occlusion value for each part. The red channel of this map represents the mouth cavity mask, used to keep the inner mouth from participating in the roughness value for the face. White areas take effect while black areas don't. The green channel of this map represents the mouth gradient ambient occlusion for the inner mouth and tints the base color so that the inside of the mouth does not light up. The blue channel of this map is used to control the ambient occlusion for the nostrils and tints the base color so that the nostrils are properly occluded. The alpha channel of this map is used to control the ambient occlusion for the inner ring of the lips and tints the base color to dim this area. Finally, I'll talk about the application of the shader. I can select multiple materials of the digital human shader inside the material list and adjust the slider parameters at once. For example, I can adjust the base color strength, normal strength, diffuse color, etc. By adjusting the different SSS falloff colors and the appropriate SSS radius and roughness, I can create a material that resembles a jade stone. I hope you have learned a lot, and make sure to check forums.realillusion.com for more up-to-date information. I hope to see you soon in the next video.